I recently discovered this photography thing called a color walk, which is basically you grab your camera, you choose a color, and you go out for a walk and take pictures of things that are of your chosen color. This isn't really something that I do normally as an activity, but I thought it'd be a nice change. But since I'm on my skateboard, it wouldn't really be a color walk. So I'm calling it a color skate. So I went out for a color skate over a couple of days, and the color that I chose was red. I thought that that might be a nice contrast between the yellows, greens, and browns that I was expecting to see on the trail that I wanted to do my color skate on. I was really hoping that I didn't just have a bunch of pictures of street art, which I know is around that area. So let's see how I went. I'm in my first location, which is under an overpass. There's some traffic going overhead, which you might be able to hear. There's some street art behind me, which I'm gonna take some pictures of. Hopefully I get some nice shadows across it as well, and find something else that's red for my color scape. Okay, I found an abandoned teddy bear that I'll take a picture of if I can walk up these precarious rocks. Here we go. So I'm in my second location, which is this bridge. There's some nice red brick, which is on what looks like an old railway crossing. I'll try to take a few pictures around this area. One thing I have noticed so far on this color skate is that I'm paying more attention to my surroundings because I'm exploring. I'm trying to look for things that are red that I can take some pictures of. But one thing I saw a lot of was waste. There's lots of kind of trash around. I'm not saying that people are dumping rubbish around here, but there's a river that runs along this entire trail, and it's more likely that our waste gets into these waterways and it gets distributed out throughout this area. And it's disappointing to see. And it just makes me think about how we manage our waste and how we can improve. Okay, so I found this thing, whatever it is. I don't even know if it's meant for skateboarding, but I'm terrible at skate parks or ramps. But in the spirit of exploration, I had a try. I looked terrible, but I think that's what the spirit of this color skate is. It's going out, exploring your environment, and trying new things and experiencing new things. So that's why I gave it a go. So that was my color skate. I did have a lot of fun just being outside and experiencing my local environment. I did divert away a little bit from the brief and just started taking pictures of anything that didn't have to be red. But I think that's the important thing. It's about just being outside, because these days that can be taken away from us or heavily reduced. And it's an important thing for our mental health. So this is an activity that I really did enjoy. I will do again. It's a good activity for solo or duo. In the groups, it might be a little bit hard because of the constant stop starting. If you want to do it as a group activity, you'd potentially want to have designated areas where you stop and you just take pictures, if that's what you want to do. But it's definitely a fun activity and worthwhile to be outside together. So I hope you enjoyed the color skate and you try it for yourself. It doesn't have to be a color skate. It could be a coffee skate, where you ride around to different cafes and you try their coffees. I can't recommend a beer skate because in Australia, if you're caught over the limit on your skateboard, you could actually lose your license. But there are other things you can do. I'll catch you in the next video.